Hey guys, so today I was running the usual maintenance on this old desktop PC, and there's a very interesting observation that I wanted to share with you guys. And the observation is related to CPU coolers, or as they are known as heatsink fans. And this particular machine here is based on a Ryzen 2400G CPU, and this CPU comes with the usual AMD Wraith style CPU cooler, which you can see over here. And this is the fan, and this is the heatsink. But here today I have placed it next to its elder brother, and the elder brother is this thing. This is an absolute beast of a CPU cooler, and this thing came out of an AMD AM2 socket, which is a pretty old socket, I guess at least 15 years old today. So this is a socket AM2 based cooler, and this is an AM4 based cooler, which is the latest Ryzen socket. And let's take a quick comparison at these things. So this is the old guy over here, the 15 year old beast, and this is the new guy on the block. So here, notice anything? So the old AM2 socket cooler is at least twice as tall as this new kid, and it's at least three times as heavier. So you can see that the fins are much taller than this thing, and plus there's this heavy thick aluminium plate kind of structure which helps spread out the heat. So all of this is just a solid block of aluminium, and this is the reason that this CPU cooler is so heavy. So here's a comparison once again. You can see how big this thing is. Yes, talking about the big things, the fan on this latest CPU cooler is slightly larger. You can say wider. So this thing does run a little bit more silently, you can say. But in the end, I found out that this CPU cooler was just as silent as this thing. The reason being due to this huge hunking metal mass. The CPU temperatures are so well in control that you don't need to raise the fan speed of this tiny fan. And equivalently, the noise level of both of these things is pretty much similar, at least in my testing scenario. And yes, when we are talking about the testing, we need to talk about the temperatures. And let me tell you guys, so when you go on any AMD based forum, you can see that there are a lot of guys complaining with this stock AMD Wraith cooler. It's not pretty good. The gaming temps often cross 90 degrees Celsius, especially if you live in a very hot country like I live in India. So the CPU is not at all happy with thing, and a lot of people are talking about upgrading these things. But when I went back to this, yes, I did actually install it over here, and we'll talk about it in a moment. So when I went back to this old guy, this old elder brother over here, the CPU temps were just fantastic. Okay, you can say that the CPU temps of this guy is as good as an entry level budget new dedicated CPU cooler for the Ryzen AM4 socket. That's how good this thing is. So if you have this old CPU cooler lying around, please do not throw it away. And I can see that a lot of computer shops have this thing lying around, and they are willing to give it away for like just 100 rupees or something. So you can go ahead and get them. And yes, they are still compatible with your AM4 socket. I'll tell you a small trick how you install them. Okay, so this is the latest Wraith cooler, the run of the mill thing, and the way it mounts is slightly different. So what it does is that it has these four screws, okay, the black screws, and here we can say that there are these four screws over here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this new Wraith cooler just directly screws on like this on your CPU. But the earlier motherboards used to have these plastic retention clips, or you can say the mounts. And my motherboard was pretty lucky. So this is a B450M motherboard from Gigabyte, and it did come with these optional clips pre-installed. If your motherboard did not come with this, you can find these clips in the junk, or you can just remove them from your old motherboard from where you removed this thing. You can just open these four screws and install it on your AM4 socket motherboard. And by using these retention clips, so there's a claw over here, there's a claw over here, you can install this old beast of a CPU cooler just like this. I won't be able to demonstrate using one hand, but this clip, this metal thing, okay, this thing, it latches over here onto this plastic clip like this, and it does fit beautifully, and it does perform very well like this. So here is how it's going to look, and it's going to perform very nicely. And before ending this video, I want to just talk about one thing, that yes, old is gold, and it is very much true today. Yes, I can understand that today's CPUs are much more efficient. So this is a 65-watt TDP. Older CPUs were hotter. But yes, we can also see that those benefits are not passed on to the consumers, because the cost cutting is a very real thing, and the temperatures have actually gone up due to this thing. So you may want to try it out, and you may want to let me know in comments below if this old AM2 CPU cooler worked for you. It did work very beautifully for me. And yes, if you're interested in learning more about desktop computers, their modifications, the cooling and so on, there's a whole playlist waiting for you in the description below. The playlist is known as Information Technology. Please go ahead and check it out. So that is it for today's video, guys. I hope you liked it. Take care and have a nice day.